from what I can see, other than the increase in fees, and maybe some instances where class sizes have increased, there's not been much impact to the students. There's been some whining about the increase in the tuition because it went up from about $3,000 to $5,000 overnight. I shouldn't say whining, it's a fair complaint. I think some students were grandfathered in at the old price for one semester, maybe two. There was some scare that we heard that the Saudi Arabian Commission or consulate wouldn't tolerate the increase in price, and Saudis had been 50% of our population, but in fact, we've been playing catch up with the teachers for two semesters and recruiting up until the week before the semester started. We're also getting a lot more Chinese students now. There really is a shift, you know, from being very Arabic, we are now becoming very Arabic and Asian. But I haven't noticed a dramatic change in my classes. But then again, I'm not teaching pathway EAP courses. Maybe there's less diversity over there. I think that over time, we'll look back and say, my God, remember when we had all those Arabic students? I think we'll look back. But so far, it's been a very gradual shift. You've probably noticed the sort of branding of Passagemaker in the buildings, and I've mentioned the attempt to sort of brand the instructors as well. Well, the students also get branded at Passagemaker, and most seem to embrace it. There are always tons of t-shirt giveaways. They actually had, ice removers for your car. Like, we need that in Arizona. And so there is that sense, you know, that if you wear a Passagemaker t-shirt or you're a Passagemaker student on campus, you're labeled positively or negatively or whatever. It's a shame you're not interviewing students, the Passagemaker students, as well as the other DHU students.